Jordi here again, your instructor for Cinecom.net, and welcome to my course. In this video, we are going to create an animation. And again, as I've said in the previous lesson, it's one of the things that thrilled me the most when I was learning Premiere for the first time. So let's dive into this awesome technique. We are going to create an animation. So that means, for example, make a text go from one point in your screen, go to another point. We can also do this on video clips, photos, etc. Let's start with the basics. I'm going to create a new title. So click on the New Item button in your project panel, say title, give it a name, for example, animated text, and press OK. And from here, I'm going to type in a title and I'm going to say Jordi, which is my name. Take your selection tool and I'm just going to drag this a little bit bigger like this. And I'm also going to center it up with these two buttons. And then I'm going to close the title designer and drag my title from the project panel inside my timeline. So what we have now is actually just a static text. When I'm going to play this, you will see that nothing much happens. So we would like to animate this text so that it goes from the left side to the right side. Now you have to see this as going from point A to point B in a certain time. So we are going to work with time. Let's say that point A is somewhere right here in the time, then we are going to set point B somewhere right there in time. Now where can we set those points? What we have to do is go to the effects controls. And we have seen this. Premiere's asking us to select a clip first. So let's select that clip, and now we can see some properties in here. And these are all things that we have seen in this course. Let's open up the motion. So our goal is to animate this text from the left to the right. So we can do that with the position. And if I'm going to change this value, like so, we can already see it somehow being animated. But this is not something that is being recorded now. No, we are just setting a static value. So actually what we have to do is animate this value right here. And to animate this, we have to open up a second timeline. Now that timeline can be found on the right side. And if you can't see it yet, like I do, you actually have to show that timeline by pressing on this button right here, which says Show or Hide the Timeline View. Click on it, and that will open up a mini timeline. You can also enlarge this a little bit by standing on the intersection of your parameters options and your timeline view here, and then just drag it to the left side a little bit bigger. Now, this timeline does not represent the timeline below here. It only represents, when I've got this clip selected, a timeline of the clip that you have selected. Let me show this to you a little bit better. I'm going to open up the clips folder inside my project panel and just drag any of these clips to my timeline, like so. Now, if this would represent my whole timeline, when I'm at the end of the timeline inside the effect controls, I should also be at the end of my global timeline, which I am not. So now you can actually visually see what this timeline over here represents. While I am moving this time indicator, you can also see the time indicator moving down below here. So that is something you definitely have to understand pretty well. So we are ready to start with the animation now. I'm going to delete this clip that I have added and select my text again. Let's start with the animation now. We are at point A now, and we would like to save the current position that we are in at now. And to save that position, we have to enable the stopwatch or toggle the animation on by clicking on this icon on the left side of the position. Click on it, and automatically the first point has been saved inside a keyframe. That is the name of this point. When talking about animations, we are also talking about keyframing, because that is what we're doing here. And next we have to select point B in time. So just scrub with your time indicator to point B, which is further away in time, and now select the second point. And we can do that by just changing the value now. So I'm going to move it to the right side. There we go. And automatically again, Premiere has created a second keyframe because Premiere saw that the value has changed for the position. And since we have the animation enabled, it will automatically create that keyframe. And this is basically it. When I'm now going to play this clip inside my timeline, you will see that the text will go from point A to point B. And our first animation has been created. Isn't that awesome? Now, this might go too slow for you. So in order to make this text go faster from point A to point B, we just have to decrease the time between it. So just grab any of these keyframes and move them closer to each other. And when I'm now going to play this clip, you will see that my text will go a lot faster to point B. Now you can see that every parameter has one of these stopwatches. And that means that we can all keyframe them, even at the same time. So let's also do that for the scale. I'm going to stand on the exact same point for the position in point A here. And I'm going to enable also the animation for the scale. And let's start with a value of somewhere around 50. I've got a keyframe per point A. I'm going to move to my final position right here, point B, and increase that value. And when I'm now going to play this, two animations will be played, the position and the scale. Look at that. Isn't that awesome again? Now, not only with these basic parameters, but also with the effects inside the effects library. Let's add that fast blur again to our text. Fast blur right here. Drag that to your text file. And in your effect controls now, we can also find that stopwatch for the blurriness. So again, I'm going to move to my point A somewhere, toggle the animation on, and I would like to start from a blurry text, like so. And on the second point here, point B, I'm going to make this zero, this value, so that the text is nice and sharp. And when I'm now going to play this, also that blurriness has been keyframed or animated now. Let's take this even a step further. I'm going to head back to my project panel, close up my clips folder, and create a new title. Title, and I'm going to name this Next Step Animation. There we go. Press OK. And for now, I'm going to say Jordy Awesome. Take my selection tool, and I'm going to center it up again in the middle. Close your titler. And from here, I'm going to drag in my title into the timeline. So now I've got two text files in my timeline. And the second text is still static because we haven't done any animations on it yet. Now, what we are going to do is I'm going to start in the beginning here, open up the motion settings inside my effect controls, and I'm going to set point number A with the position. And that is going to be somewhere around here in the corner. Create a keyframe for it. Move a little bit further in time. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to select motion because I had this icon right here. So I know that I can visually change its position. We have seen that in this course. And I'm now just going to drag my title to a different position. And what you can see right here now is the actual path of the animation that the text is going to run through. And we can set another point. I'm going to move further in time and drag this text again to a next point. And look what happens here now. The actual path is bending over here so that the animation will actually go smooth. Now, this bending curve here is being defined by these two points over here. And I can actually take this point right here and define how much that point has to curve. Also, the beginning point has one of those anchors. Just take that and bend that point so that you can select the actual path of your animation. And when I'm now going to play this, you will see that the text will beautifully follow that path that we've created. So we are able to create multiple keyframe points in an animation, and if we are able to visually change the effect settings, then we can also, in most cases, change the animation or the keyframing visually by just selecting that effect. Now let's create a third text. Again, in my project panel, click on the new item button and say title. And this is going to be my third text. There we go. Press OK. And in here, I'm just going to say third text, like so. Take my selection tool and align it into the middle. Close that window, the titler, and drag in your title into the timeline. So again, we've got one static text. Now, what I'm going to do is select it again, open up my motion, and create two keyframes so that my text starts on the left side, create a keyframe, go a little bit further in time, and create a new keyframe, like so. Now, when I'm going to play this text in here, you will see that it actually starts very abrupt and that it also ends very abrupt. This doesn't really feel natural. In order to make this animation go much more natural, we actually have to smoothen these keyframes so that the text will accelerate while it's going. And to do so, we can right-click on one of these keyframes, head over to temporal interpolation, and say ease out. Because the animation is going out from this point. It's not because it's the first keyframe that we have to select ease in, now we have to select ease out. Click on that, and now you can also see the keyframe changing a little bit. And we're going to do the exact same thing for the second keyframe, but now we're going to select, right-click, say temporal interpolation, and say ease in, because the animation is coming from the left to the right, so it's going in into the keyframe. So again, temporal interpolation, ease in. And when I'm now going to play this, you will now see that the text will accelerate slowly and also end slowly, much smoother as before. And this is a professional animation. And this is what an amateur animation will distinguish what a professional animation. So there is a great tip. For a final example, I'm going to create one last text file. I'm going to say again, new item, title, and I'm going to say title number 4. Press OK. And as the text, I'm going to say with the text tool in here, I'm going to say fourth title. Take my selection tool and center it up in the middle. Close your title designer, and I'm going to drag in title number 4 next to the third text title file. So again, we've got this static text in here. Now with this clip selected, head over to motion, and what I want to do now is make an animation so that my third title here actually starts. I'm just going to select the motion somewhere right here. So for that, I'm going to define a point number A, but keep in mind your time indicator. So let's start somewhere right here in the beginning of that clip. Create a keyframe for the position. I'm going to head a little bit further in time now. Select point number B, which is somewhere right here. And now I would like this title to stay there for a couple of seconds and then go to point number C, which is going to be somewhere right here. What we then have to do is go a little bit further in time to the point where the pause actually ends and the title is going to move again to point number C. And right here, we want to create a keyframe with the same value as the keyframe before, so that the title will stick there. Now, to create a keyframe with the same value that we already have, we have to click on this button right here, which will add a new keyframe if we are not standing on one, or it will remove a keyframe if we are already standing on that keyframe. So let's just do that. I'm going to click on it, and that will create a new keyframe with this value here, which is selected. But if I click on it again, it will remove that keyframe. I think that is pretty obvious. But let's just create a keyframe now. So now from this point to that point, nothing has changed. So the title is just going to stick there. And when I'm now going to move further in time and select the next point, somewhere around there, you will now see that when I'm going to play this title, that it will pause for a moment between these two keyframes, as they have the exact same value. Pause, and it will move again. There we go. And again, if some sort of a pad goes too fast or too slow for you, you can just move these keyframes in here. You can also select multiple keyframes, like this boss for example, and move them both to the left or to the right side. This is something that you have to play with. Now, as an advice, this is something which isn't always that easy to understand. Now, keyframing or animating is not so easy if you are a beginner for Premiere. I also faced this problem where the animation was doing things that I didn't ask for. And that is normal, because this is a big box of information that you're getting here. So my advice is to re-watch this lesson again if you are struggling with this technique. And also, give it some time. You will bump into some trouble where the animation won't do the things that you ask for. It's absolutely normal. So then just try to find what is wrong, try to look at your keyframes, what you're actually doing here. And always keep in mind that you are running in time. You are always going from a point A, which is laying somewhere in time, to a point B, which is laying somewhere in a different time. And if you understand that, the process of keyframing will go a lot easier. So that's it for keyframing. I want to thank you a lot for watching. You can also download this project right here so that you have all these title files here with the keyframes that I have set within this lesson. In the next video lesson, I'm going to teach you some more tips and tricks when it comes down to all the things that we have already seen in this course. And after that, I'm going to close this chapter and start with a whole new chapter. So stay tuned for the next video, and again, thanks for watching.